morning to all the friends. So this mass is offered to the bodies of our dear Raju, Aloysius, Raymond, and Rita Raymond, Terry Mon, those of us, Globina, Ridley, and all the intentions. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Everywhere of Blessed Mary, O Lord, all the angels and saints.
the Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, lives and reigns in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Thank you. Is it possible? All this is not. Then later on, This is the promise of saying, my Lord and my God.
The crucifixion and death of Jesus threatened
very badly.
Frightened the muscles. They are terribly insecure.
The John's Gospel, chapter 20, verses 19, we read about peace be with you are the first words Jesus spoke to his apostles. After his word, we need that peace. Maybe in the world, in our country, in our state, in our family, in our parish too, in ourselves too, we need a peace.
Peace is not like quiet.
Keep it quiet, no, that is not peace.
Take state of nothing going on and not being restored by anyone.
That's not the peace. St. Augustine would say, is a general quality that comes from order and order is simply the proper arranging all the parts.
In other words, peace is the purposeful flow of life.
Smoothly should go. That's a peaceful batch. They say peaceful batch.
Smoothly going everything.
Time to time. Nothing disturbs us. So this is a peace.
That is constantly adjusting order of things.
So different tasks. And today we go, I think many are busy in the parish or place. It's a golden jubilee celebration.
The nuncio is going to come, he celebrates Thanksgiving Mass.
Many are busy.
So that way, all of the things that we should go smoothly, peacefully.
Oh, we need to pray to God.
All in the home. But for the peace to reign in families and community, all in the world, there must be peace first within the individuals.
Within the individuals. Without peace in us, we cannot expect peace in society, in others. That is the reason peace be with you. The greeting is very important. In the mass also, we greet the peace be with you, the Lord and with you.
Peace demands a mentality and a spirit which you go turning to others must first pervades into who wishes to bring peace. Peace is a first and foremost personal before it is social, said Pope John Paul II. Peace of Christ gives health. It is a healing power. It was with his power that the Creator, after the resurrection of the Lord, healed the sick.
Acts chapter 5, verse 16 says,
crowds from the towns around the Jerusalem would gather, bringing the sick.
All whom he was bringing, there were crowds of people. I've been there sometime to Lourdes. I've seen all the sick people they come for procession. I think some of them might have gone, maybe with God's grace. I've seen that the healing power, the God's presence, many volunteers from power to help the sick to heal. That's a peaceful presence. That's all that is going. Thousands of people gather there. The brochure said, I see hundreds of people. We cannot go there. We cannot count. Such a crowd was going smoothly. All the activities arranged systematically. But I felt it is a very peaceful way of celebration.
Peace of Christ free us from all fear.
As we heard in the gospel, the disciples are disturbed when Jesus was not there. In the absence of Jesus, they disturbed.
They insecure them. They felt fear
that they will arrest, they may kill.
There are times when the sea of our life becomes rolled with storms of doubt and tensions in us.
So So Revelation chapter 1 verse 17 says, there is nothing to fear. I am the first and the last and the one who lives. The risen Christ is with us now. Peace of Christ frees from fear of death. Adam has made death other than death. Death is never sweet, not even when it is support for pious guidance. Hence all fear death. Let me believe that our faith is a share in the resurrection of Him who gives us. It's the book of Revelation chapter 1 verse 18. Once I was dead, now I live. I hold the keys of death. We believe in eternal life, which is not a pleasing illusion. We believe that the resurrection of Jesus has touched every piece of human life. After the resurrection, every healing has become a partial resolution, change of life. And today's modern world we have, we need to reflect a little bit. We are all tensed, tension, busy, disturbed, noisy world. Where is the peace? Who can give a peace? Here is the Jesus has come to give us peace. Like the apostles, sometimes we too are reluctant to accept the risen Lord. Is it possible to give peace to Jesus in this world? Is it possible that Russia and Ukraine want to be stopped? Who can stop? Who can tell them? From the hostages we need to reflect. John saw the risen Lord clearly in his vision. One who died but it will live for evermore. He has brought life. He overcame death. Yes, my dear sisters and brothers. So as the celebrating the event was this Sunday, it is of Jesus. And many times we doubt, we are failing. And then we know. Past 2 years, because of the COVID, we are unable to experience that, the faith in the Lord. Walking with the Lord, speaking with the Lord, now it is God has made us. We are in this 40 days of our prayer and fasting, surely helps us, each one of us. There's something different in us, the peace in us, the newness in us. We need to update ourselves. Let us turn to God and walk in the path of God. As we celebrate this feast, once again I wish all of you a very happy feast of divine mercy. May the good Lord give us that peace, happiness, especially our parish, as we today we go to celebrate the Golden Jubilee Mass for the Apostolic Ministry of India. Let us pray for all the programs that go smoothly. May good Lord bless each one of us. Amen. This is the time of the Sophie. We will go.
The Father of the Christ, Creator of the earth, of all things visible and invisible, I pray.
And rose again on the third day, in accordance with the scriptures. He
proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in God, the Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Prayer of the faithful, dear brothers and sisters, on this special day of Divine Mercy, we all of us learn how to drink from the abundant flow of love and mercy from the pierced heart of Jesus, the source of Divine Mercy.
You respond gently, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For your servant Pope Francis, our Archbishop, and all the bishops, all the priests and religious, protected by the shield of your merciful love, may they all be channels of your mercy in a broken world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the leaders and policy makers that they experience the power of your merciful love and free from selfish interests. May they work for the good of all people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the victims of war and violence, terrorism and fanaticism, refugee and exile. May they experience your fatherly care and mercy in their trying days. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who doubt and have lost faith in the sacrament of reconciliation, that their faith may be enlivened in the knowledge of Christ, and have merciful love and forgiveness of sins. Then approach the sacrament, trusting in your mercy and compassion. We pray to God.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep in our intentions. O God, hear the prayers of your people who cry unto you. In your mercy and love, raise us up to the new and eternal life purchased by the priceless blood of your Son Jesus, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed be the Almighty Father.
Mystery of praise.
giving thanks that the heaven is worthy to be in our presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray the parting of the body and blood of Christ, we will be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember all your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, because the Pope Francis, be the Archbishop, now the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who are fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all the old kind of mercy welcome them in the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints, we are pleased to you throughout the ages, we merit to be co-eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. When you pray,
let us pray.
Last Sunday Easter classes, vigil, and day classes.